very warm good morning to all of you. Myself Tejashree Shirsagar, and as you know, I am going to teach you biology. From the biology, already we have discussed first lesson, already we have completed one lesson, that is cell. So today we will go for the next lesson. Today we will start the lesson, and the name of that lesson is what? Crop production and management. So before going to discuss about the lesson in deep, we will discuss about the lesson name. So why it is necessary to learn or to get to know more idea about the crop production and management? So what is meant by crop production and management? What we are going to see in the lesson? So the crop production means what? We have to produce, or how the farmer is producing the different types of the crops, or different types of the grains, pulses, cereals, different vegetables and the fruits. Wow, how they are doing that, which are the different steps they are following, or which types of the instruments they are using to do all that things. All these things we will going to see in this lesson. How, which modern techniques they are using to increase the production. Next one is that what? Management. And how they are managing all these things, different steps, different instruments, how they are managing, and by doing all these different work, at the end we are getting the different types of the food material. Okay, so this is all about what? Crop production and management. So the next thing is that why to learn this lesson. So as we know, our India is a very beautiful country, and still it is best as a, or it is known as a agriculture based country. So 70% of the population is based, or the 70% of the people in the country is related to the agriculture. Okay, or their occupation is what? Agriculture. So we all are directly or indirectly depends on the agriculture, because as you know, if I'll ask you what you have today in the meal, then you can say that I have idli, dosa, then I have chapati, roti, rice. So have you ever thought from where we are getting all this food material? So we are getting this all this food material ready made at the home, but behind that food material there is a very big process. Okay, so all these things we are getting from the agriculture. Okay, so we will discuss all these things in this lesson, that is what? Crop production and management. So before going to see the lesson, why we are doing the agriculture, why there are the different types of the crops, vegetables and fruit? Because all these are known as what? Food. And the food is the one of the basic need of an human being. So why we need the food? Why we have to take the food every day? So let's see why we need the food. Food. Why we need the food? We need the food to get energy. So why we need the energy? To walk, to run, to move, or to do the different or the several activities, we requires the energy. And that energy we are getting from what? Food. Next one, food will require from the food. Food is necessary for proper growth of our body, development of our body, and also very important, the food is necessary to repair our body. Now repair means what? Sometimes curses happens in our body, but with the time pass it gets healed. Okay, so how it gets healed? With the help of the different cell, or with the help of the different nutrients that we are getting from the food. So for that purpose also we require the food. For what? For growth, for development, and to repair the body. Next one, to protect the body against diseases. We require the food to protect the body against diseases. So as we know, there are the different types of the nutrients are there. We can say that carbohydrates, fats, protein, vitamins and minerals. And each nutrient is having specific role in our diet. So as we know, vitamins and the minerals are called as protective food. Why? Because they help to protect our body. And from where we are getting the vitamins and minerals? From the food, which helps to protect the body against the diseases. Now the next one, we will see that food is required to carry different life processes. Now different life processes means what? Okay, for example, we can say that there are the so many, as we know, the human body is like a machine. So many work is going on in our body. So there are so many processes are also going on in our body. There is a circulation, there is a reproduction, respiration, breathing, digestion. So many things are going on in our body. And to perform all these processes very well, our body requires the energy. And as we know that energy we are getting from what? Food. So all these purpose we require the food. Okay? So here we have discussed that why we need food. But have you know from where we are getting this food? Yes. So there are the two main sources of the food. Means there are the two ways, and from that two ways we are getting the food. And the two sources of the food are plants and animals. So either the food we are getting from the plants or either the food we are getting from the animals. Okay. So the plants food we can say that different vegetables, fruits, all these are the vegetable, all these are the food material that we are getting from the plants. Okay. Why we can say that from the animals we can get the egg, meat, fish, milk, okay, honey, all these are the foodstuffs that we are getting from the animals. Okay. So whatever we are having in our daily life or in our diet, either it comes from the plants or it comes from the animals. So the plants and the animals are the main sources of food. But in this there is a major difference. There is a very important thing regarding the plants and the animals. So as we know, plants can make their own food with the help of using some raw materials. Raw materials like we can say that carbon dioxide and water, and in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight, they combines the carbon dioxide and water and makes their own food in the form of C6H12O6. C6H12O6, that is nothing but what? Carbohydrate, we can say that. And they also release what? Oxygen. Okay. They also release the oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. So only the plants on this universe, in this universe, can make their own food. And as we know, in our previous classes we have discussed about the nutrition in plants. Okay. So plants are making their own food, and the organisms, those who are making their own food, that organisms are called as what? Autotrophs. Okay, or that mode of nutrition is called as what? Autotrophic mode of nutrition. So the plants are what? Autotrophs. And remaining all organisms are depends on plants for their food. So the animals cannot make their own food. For their food they are depends on other, and the organism, those who are depends on other for their food, that organisms are called as what? Heterotrophs. Okay, so here we have discussed about what? Plants are autotroph, while animals are heterotroph. And each and every organism depends on plants for their need of food. Means from the plants, each and every organism is getting the food. For example, we can say that plants are there. So herbivores will eat the plants, and the herbivorous animals will be eaten by the carnivorous animal. So in this way, each and every organism, each and every animal directly or indirectly depends on the plants for their food. Okay? And the plants are making their own food by the process, and that process is called as what? Photosynthesis. Okay? So what they are using in the photosynthesis? They use the carbon dioxide, water, and in the presence of, they combine, in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight, they combine these two things and forms their food in the form of carbohydrate, and also they release what? Oxygen. Okay? So in this way they are doing their own food, that's why they are called as what? Autotrophs. Okay. Now we'll discuss about here we have discussed that plants are making their own food. We all require the food. But now we'll discuss about the ancient age. Okay, or the ancient people. So let's go in the story mode. Let's discuss about the story of the ancient age. So as we know, the ancient people were nomadic. They were living the nomadic life. Now nomadic life means what? The one who continuously changing the place, the one who continuously shifting from one place to another place. Okay, so the ancient people were nomadic. Why they are to another place in search of food or in search of shelter. So what was the food for the ancient people? Which type of the food they were having? They were having the raw vegetables, raw fruits or the raw roots. Okay. Also, they are hunting the animals and they are eating the flesh of that animals. Okay. So in this way, they are living their life. But as we know, slowly, slowly the population in the ancient time were also increasing. Okay. And after the some days, whatever, after the certain time, the population get increased. But the number of animals remains the same. As compared to the number of population, the number of animals was not yet increased. Okay. So that time there was a scarcity for the ancient people to hunt the animal. So that time they started to think, or they started to think about the alternatives for the hunting. And then they find out the alternatives for that hunting. That is nothing but what? They started to do the farming. Okay. They started to do the farming. They started to sow the seeds into the soil, and they are started to grow the different types of the plants. Okay. And from that, or from there, the term agriculture started, or the agriculture comes out, or this term agriculture born from that time. Okay. Slowly, slowly, ancient people started to grow the different crops, and at that time they stopped hunting, rather hunting the animals. They started to keep the animals with them as a domestic animal. That time they were having dog, cows, buffalo, and so many other animals. But that time they are keeping the animals for as their domestic animals. Okay. So in this way, this agriculture terms born. Okay. So now we will discuss about the definition of agriculture. So what is the definition of agriculture? Agriculture is an applied science that deals with the mass production of crop, plants and animals useful to human being. Okay. So the agriculture is nothing but what? The production of crops in a plenty or in a vast. Okay. So the production of plants, or you know, mass production of crop plants means to produce the plants in a more amount, not only the plants but what? And animals useful to human being. From animals also we are getting some things. Okay. So in this way, this was the this is the definition for agriculture. Once again I will repeat, agriculture is an applied science that deals with what? The mass production of crop, plants and animals useful to human beings. Okay. So what we will what we have discussed today, let's revise. You know, we need the food for the different reasons: to get energy, for growth, development, body repair. Also food helps to protect the body. It carries a different life process. There are the two main sources of the food, that are plants and animals. Plants are called as autotrophs. Animals are called as heterotrophs. Plants are making their own food with the help of photosynthesis process. And also we have seen the definition of the agriculture and how the agriculture term get born. Okay. So this is the time. Today I will tell you goodbye. I will see you in the next video. For today, thank you.